Hello everyone, this is Christina with Kilburn's Creations. I am finally putting my pages together for the baby book. And I'm gonna start with this one. In the last video, I showed you how I had the white layouts done. Then I started videoing them on how I was gonna put them together and all. And I feel that it's going to be a whole lot easier to do it with the pieces as I go. So I went ahead and I picked all my colors out from my papers and all. So this one here, that's the front page or the base page of it. This one is going to be the flip back one that I've been talking about doing. And these I just needed to fold down to size. Okay, so what did I get done here so far? There's that one. That. Okay, so did you fit this one? No. Okay, well, first of all, I want to fold, get these scored and folded so this one will go here, and I'm doing half inch score lines foldovers. So I'm going to do, want to do all my white pieces except for the belly band. Now this is not the one I thought it was. Is it? That gets folded this way, then this gets this way. Yeah, this is it. Okay. Your pocket. I was putting a pocket on it too. Okay. So all of these tabs will be scored at a half an inch. Same size? Why is that the same size? Okay, one of those is a pocket, I think. And this one goes at a half an inch. And then the pocket, I actually think I'm going to want it to be wider than that. See? All these are scored. That one. Let's set that to the side. Okay. So what I need to do now is I need to ink my edges. Not wanting a whole lot, just enough to give it some color. Calm down some of that white. Not that part. Take a few minutes longer than I expected. Where do I put you guys at? Okay, so what I need to do and see which one you will fit. This one's going to be. Oh, I didn't do both sides of you. Whoa. Okay, use up the smaller pieces first. Okay. big enough to go onto this one. Second one here. So I'm going to use approximately an eighth of an inch. Where's my pencil? I'm going to draw a mark here. Make it that mark instead. And then a mark right about here. So get this all set up. And slice this here right at that pencil mark. And then we need to slice it on this side. Hi, honey. Cut another one. Let's go with this one. It's the same size for the back. Cool. Put a little mark right here where that one is. Put a little mark right here where this one is. And let's see. We'll go this way first. Line that pencil mark right up to the edge. Cut. And then this one can be turned and cut again. So those should be your pieces. One on the front and one on the back. Right? No, I need to do another quarter inch. Yeah, let's do another quarter inch here. Or eighth an inch. I don't like to measure, so I usually guess at it. Or go by my pencil line. But just a hair more. And how does that look? Yes, I like that better. Okay, so that one is ready. I need a large one. Let's go with the horses. I like these horses. They are cute. So we are going to lay this down. It's right about here. We're going to want that to come up a little bit and this to come over a little bit. So my pencil, we are going to cut right about here. And right about here. So let's cut the top off here. And then we are going to cut it. It was by a tail right there. Right like that. Make sure it's straight. Okay. Awfully skinny, that's all. And then this way comes right here at that pencil mark. I think that's the pencil mark. Yeah. That's the pencil mark. Right there. Okay, so I need another one that's this size. Let's go with the stripes on this one. So this will get lined up here and here. We will cut here and here. Cut this top part off. Off on that, huh? How far out? Yep. Maybe I should take my glasses off. My glasses are for me not seeing far away. I can see close up. Let's see if this one will curl. I think it's so neat when they curl. No. See that this one curled? Get them thin enough they curl on you. Okay, and then this one goes right here on that pencil line. This and this should be the same size. Not quite. This one is just a hair bigger. That one curled. Whoops, where'd it go? That one curled. Isn't that neat how it curls like that? So now do you two match? Now they fit. They're the same size anyways. And yes, they will work. Okay, so there's that one. I see the bigger piece here. Is it enough on this one? No. What about the plaid? Is there enough of that plaid? No. Okay. Let's go with the boy. Let's see, this is going to be opening this way, so we want the words to go that way. So we want this one right about here, and this one right about here. Okay, since this has to be long ways, I'm going to cut this way off. Don't need those tabs. Mm-hmm. That one okay? Yes, it will. So let's grab another piece. Pull you out of the way. This one has to go this way. And let's get it out of the thing here. Right to the edge. As you can see, I hate to measure. Every time I measure, it's not right anyway, so let's go it like this. Okay, that one is done. Two more to go. Oh, that went the long way. That was probably for the pocket. That's for the belly band. Okay, what else do I have over here? Let's do another boy. Are you gonna be wide enough? Yes, you are. Is good. Now we need to do this part. Just pop this one. Not that one. This thing's got to be completely at one of the ends, otherwise it does not want to open up. It's very new. I only got it about a week ago. Well, maybe 2 weeks ago. I got it just before I started working on this book. So there's that one there. I need another one this size. Let's go with the stripe. Oh, look at that. That's not cut even. And see, that's still off just a hair. Okay, now that one is done. That goes with that. Now I need this size. Let's go with the rocking horses on this side. Mm-hmm. can do it this way first. I can go over there with the extra. And right there is my little cut. And I need another one this size. Anything over here that I can use? Let's go with this one. So that's 1, 2 1/4. Okay. Okay, I should have those feet over here. Okay, that's okay. I have my envelope one down here. Okay, so I want these corners cut. Oops. Still didn't go in there right. What's the matter? There we go. You're catching on something. Now the question is, do I want these to be curved on this outer edge or not? No, I do not. Okay. Thank you. What you doing home?
We told you we had a half day.
No, you didn't tell me that.
Oh, we have a half day.
Oh, okay. I'm filming. That was my grandson. Guess they had a half day at school today, so they are here now. They do live with us, so. Okay, I got all my corners punched. Let's get these bigger pieces out of the way over here. That can go back down on the floor. And then all my lip punches. Oh, come on. I just had you out. Should have been over here. There you are. Since I put my ruler down here so that I know I need to stay in this area while I'm working so that you all can still see it, I found it's a lot easier to pick the little things up like that than going back and forth and loading the whole tray. So what we're going to do first is get the whites in their proper places, the flaps. So these can go over to the side here. And we are going to need our tape here. So we're going to run this right down the side here. I'm going right close to the score line, but I'm not going into where it's, it goes downwards, just right next to it. Just like that. Okay, so that's going to need that. This is going to go in. I might need to do two strips of the smaller one. That is hanging over the edge. I didn't think this was a half inch though. Okay, the next ones I want to do 5/8 instead, right? No. And it is sticky. So that one will go like that. Oh no, that's not the big. This one is the one that gets folded and goes back there. Okay, so let's get this done right now. I'm going to try the two side by side. That way I can overlap them. It will give me a little bit of extra stickiness. Like that. The person I actually saw doing this to pull the tape and get a nice straight edge uses her acrylic pots for stamping. But as you can see, mine are curved, so I wouldn't get a straight line. So I just usually grab whatever's square up next to me. Now this one here, we're going to go right along the outer edge here. See how that is? It's going to overlap a little bit, but that's going to be okay. Push that down like that. Okay, so that's the first flap. Then this is the next flap. So this is going to go onto this one approximately into the middle. If we're going to fold it this way, we're just going to pull so much fun watching somebody peel off sticky back. Okay, so this is going to go like this. So we actually want to end up doing this then. And we want to go. I'm not a real precise person. I usually just eyeball it. I mean, it's not like anybody comes up and measures it to make sure you did put it in the right spot, you know. And then we fold this over like this. Huh, maybe I should be doing that too. That might stand out by not doing that. Like I said, you learn all your mistakes for boo-boos on the first one. Oh, I should have done this, I should have done that on your first one. So. And then we can get my... That's why I like working on glass. It is so much easier to clean. We're going to go ahead and leave you open for now. And just put you right back up there. Okay, so then the next size one. Will be this one. Okay, so this one gets put onto the edge like this. This one gets folded back this way. So then this one would get folded back that way. So let's get our sticky tape here. Sorry if you hear the noise. My workroom is right next to the kitchen. And with the grandkids being hungry, they live in the kitchen. Just a little bit, I thought I did. For being Teflon scissors, they stick. And it peels off easily. Don't really leave a residue, but they still stick. See, right in there. Everybody talks about the Tim Holtz ones, how they don't stick, but I don't know if I really want to pay that much money on scissors. So I peel that one off, and I peel this one off. See, we want to use this straight edge, and we are going to stick this right about here and bring this right up along that fold, right on the edge of this glue. So this folds this way, and then this folds this way, and I need to I didn't think about that. Did the edges before I folded them? Did gotta do this one back here, yes. This one here still needs to be done. This one go right here and get folded that way. So let's get one of these. Right next to the score line again. This time we're going to go right to the edge again. See, it overlaps a little bit right there, so this one goes this way. I know, my head's been getting away. But we gotta do a better job at centering. I didn't center that last one very good. There we go. And then this one, let's see here. Yeah. This one will get glued to this one here. So, okay. Let's go back and put some more color on you here. You guys covered here. Okay, so then you fold. I get confused real quick here. Okay, that goes on the side. And then this folds this. So then this is going to wrap on this one here like that. So I'm going to turn that upside down and put tape on this side. And we're going to go with the two rolls. They will overlap again, which is fine. And this one we line up along the edge here. Okay. I'm not happy with that trim. Let's trim this up a little bit right here. that right there.